Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare.
That is Brajendra Nandana Sri Krishna, is son of Nanda Maharaj. Brajendra Nandana Sri Krishna, he is asamartha, anupama. His beauty is asamartha and anupama. Understand? Same word I am repeating. Anupama, uncomparable, and asamartha. Nobody's beauty is equal to it. Nobody's beauty is superior to it. That asamartha sandarbha. He is Purna Brahma. He is known as Purna Brahma. Para Brahma, Supreme Brahma and Purna Brahma is completely full. This is significant. Purna Brahma is Sri Krishna. If someone understands him, someone gets him, that Purna Brahma, he will never feel any incompleteness. He will never feel any deficit. His life is successful. Understand me? This is Purna Brahma. If someone understands Krishna, Purna Brahma Krishna, gets him, then he'll feel no incompleteness because he has gotten Purna Brahma. He'll never feel any deficit in his life. He has gotten Purna Brahma. As long as you have not understood Purna Brahma Krishna, not gotten him, you'll feel deficit, incompleteness in your life. Understand? That is what it said. He is, because he is completely full. He is Paramananda Swarupa. He is the embodiment of Supreme Ananda, Aptakama Atmarama. He is self-satisfied. You understand? Self-satisfied. There is nothing deficit in completeness in him. He is Paripurna Rasa Vigraha, completely full and embodiment. Reservoir of all rasas, melos. He is Brahma Gopala Ujjvala Nilamani. Brahma Gopala Ujjvala Nilamani. Otherwise, with everybody you'll find there is incompleteness, there is deficit. Only in Purna Brahma Krishna there is no incompleteness, no deficit. One understands him, one gets him, he feels no deficit, no incompleteness. Otherwise, he'll feel deficit and incompleteness. That is the supreme perfection of human bhava. That is success of human life. Every jiva, jiva is very tiny. Very tiny. So every jiva feels incompleteness. There is incompleteness in every jiva and deficit. What to speak of jivas? There are differentiated parts of Krishna, Vibhinansa, isn't it? Even swansa, swansa, Vishnu tattvas, ansas, kalavataras, they have deficit. We have to speak of differentiated parts, jivas, isn't it? Nobody is Purna Brahma, only Krishna is Purna Brahma. No avatara, no Vishnu tattva is called Purna Brahma, only Krishna is known as Purna Brahma. So, Sri Krishna's madhurya, Sri Krishna's sweetness, beauty, asamartha anupama is incomparable and there is no compare to it, there is no equal to it, there is nothing superior to it. Anupama asamartha. Because he is Purna Brahma, because he is completely full, he is sarvansi, sarvavatari, sarvasaktiman. He is the source of all avataras, all visamsattvas. He is almighty, all potential. Whatever madhuryas others have, Allah, Vishnu, Tattvas, Avatars, they have madhurya. They have sweetness of beauty, because whatever they have gotten, that is one part of Purna Brahma's beauty. Understand? Because they are part. Because they are ansa and kala, they are the, what is it, plenary portion and portion of the portion. It is ansa kala punsa krishnastu bhagavan swayam. Bhagavan says, they all avatars, they are plenary portion and portion of the portion, understand? Kala, Krishna is the same Bhagavan, who is the source of all avatars and answers. Sarvansi Sarvavatari. So, Krishna's Purna Madhurya, Krishna's beauty is completely full, such uncomparable, wonderful beauty, excellent beauty, that Krishna himself becomes attracted towards it. What to speak of others? Krishna himself becomes enchanted, attracted. So, in three planetary systems, everybody has deficit, feels deficit, incompleteness. Yes. And that is manifested in this, in this five knowledge-acquiring senses. That is manifested in five knowledge-acquiring senses. What are five knowledge-acquiring senses? Are Baba, eye, tongue, nose, ear, and skin, touch. They are five knowledge-acquiring senses. The object of these five knowledge-acquiring senses, rupa, rasa, sabda, sparsa, rupa, rasa, gandha, these five tanmatra. Sabda, sound, is the object of enjoyment of ear. Sabda, sparsa, touch, the object of enjoyment of skin, touch, senses. Sabda, sparsa, rupa, form, the object of enjoyment of eye. Rasa, taste, the object of enjoyment of tongue. And gandha, smell, the object of enjoyment of smell, nose. Do you understand me? So, this abhava, this deficit is manifested through this. Sabda, spursa, rupa, rasa, gandha. Yes. How will it be completely satisfied for itrupti, where it is? Only getting Krishna. Otherwise cannot be complete or satisfied. Do you understand? So, the eye sees various forms, beautiful, more beautiful, more beautiful, so many beautiful forms. Eyes want to see. In material world, though he sees many more beautiful, still never becomes satisfied. He feels deficit and incompleteness. Similarly, they say, ear. Ear wants to hear sweet sounds. Sweeter, much sweeter sounds. Still, never feels satisfied. Feels incompleteness. Do you understand? Deficit. Similarly, this tongue wants to taste, very nice taste, palatable, more, newer, still never feels satisfied, feels incompleteness and deficit in this way. But when the eye sees the all beautiful form of Shyam Sundara, whose beauty far excels that of crows of cupids, becomes, wants to see such beauty without blinking of eyes, then he chastises Brahma. That rascal Brahma don't know how to create nicely.